If you could see the world through my eyes, vibrant purple sunrise, shards of broken dreams come raining down.
Mark here, Life and Fitness Files. Today, I wanted to give you a quick rundown of the short-term effects and what to expect when jumping into a high heart rate zone 5 anaerobic workout. This can help you to feel comfortable if you've never done this before, to know what to expect and what it might feel like, as well as the benefits and things that feel good about it. Do know this, that doing a high heart rate workout, you're gonna get a high heart rate. That's the point. When I do a high heart rate, high intensity workout, I'm typically doing this with running. So you know, I do a 4x4 protocol, 4 minutes high intensity, 4 minutes rest. 4 minutes high intensity, 4 minutes rest. I do that 4 times. So my heart rate's going to go down in between each interval, and then I spike that back up to 90%, which for me is between 170, 185, somewhere in that range, but I'm trying to get it pretty high. The thing to note that by getting your heart rate this high, your heart rate is likely to be higher throughout the day. That's normal. For me, it can be 10 to 20 beats higher than average. And a lot of times when sitting down, it can go back down. But if I get up and move, it's going to go higher than normal. Don't be alarmed. That's okay. A high intensity workout uses a lot of different resources in our bodies and works a lot of different systems, including activating different hormones. So what happens throughout the day physiologically is going to be different because of the workout that we do. If you track things like stress on a Garmin or a Whoop, you're going to see your stress be higher that day. Just know that that is normal and that's okay. This is why I do this workout early in the morning, because it could definitely impact my sleep. So I wanna get this done in the morning so that I have gone back down to baseline with my heart rate and my stress long before sleep, so it doesn't negatively impact it. So you get a high heart rate, but here's a positive: boost in mood. Most people have a boost in mood or energy after doing an intense workout. I do the intense workouts with running, thus leading to, quote, the runner's high. So this is definitely a positive. It's an awesome thing and a great reason to do this, again, first thing in the morning. So my heart rate's gonna be high, so I don't wanna impact sleep, do it in the morning. It also gives me the energy boost, get this going, and sets me for the day. You do not have to do this in the morning, but that's what I do. An important fact: lactate has often been seen as a negative, but research has shown that it's actually a fuel source for our body. It crosses the blood-brain barrier and can increase blood flow and energy. That's amazing. So high-intensity work produces a lot of lactate. In turn, it can create a lot of fuel and energy to boost us throughout the day. Going into this workout, another thing you want to keep in mind is hydration. Pretty much everyone is going to sweat when doing a high intensity workout. You want to replace any fluids that you lose during the workout plus more. The ideal number is probably 125% of fluid lost. Make sure that you go into the workout hydrated. You also want to look at hydrating during the workout. Sometimes that can be difficult in terms of trying to drink something while you're in motion. But if you're doing intervals, during those rest intervals, you can get a little bit of water in you. Then make sure to hydrate afterwards so it doesn't impact your recovery or your overall health, and you don't want to feel cruddy throughout the day. High intensity workouts are challenging, and that is the purpose. At first, they can feel a little bit daunting, but actually I find them a lot of fun. If you go into it prepared mentally and physically, you can make it a positive experience, knowing that your heart rate might be higher throughout the day, but it's likely to give you energy and raise your mood to help you go out and conquer the world. Not to mention, there's tons of long-term benefits when you do this work regularly. So thank you for watching. I'm gonna be sharing some more videos about VO2 max and high intensity work and other activities. So make sure, ask questions, let me know what you want to hear. Make sure to like and subscribe so you can stay up to date with future content. Thank you for watching, and here's to life and fitness.
Afraid of what you might lose. Walking miles and someone else's shoes.